Hello everyone, my name is Nawal Oukesh and I'm head of the Venoms and Toxins Laboratory at the Institut Pasteur of Morocco. My team's activity revolves around the characterization of snake and scorpion venoms to a therapeutic end, whether it be for drug discovery or the conception of antivenom. Today, I'm going to talk about scorpion venoms and envenomation in Morocco. The animal kingdom represents about 8 million species. About 500,000 of them are venomous. They can be found in all fellow and all are spread all around the planet, on Earth, in the air, and underwater. While one might think venom is made of one molecule that kills, natural evolution designed complex venomous apparatus for prey capture and defense. Indeed, each venom is different and each is made of dozens or hundreds of molecules, is typically highly potent and selective for biological target. Why the cocktail kills, but some of this molecule can heal. A fascinating word, isn't it? My presentation will focus on scorpion covered by about 2,000 species, of which only 10% are really dangerous, but they kill. First, we will be looking at the composition of their venoms, their toxins, and the mode of action. We will then move to the aspect of scorpion envenomation, focusing on North Africa, especially Morocco. And finally, I will present you some of our recent development of antivenom against the most dangerous envenomation in the Maghreb. We start with the part of scorpion venom characterization, and I will present to you some of our work research of the most dangerous scorpion venoms in Morocco, namely Androctonus mauritanicus and Betus occitanus, and in the Maghreb, namely Betus occitanus and Androctonus australis hector. First, our work starts with the collection of scorpions in their biotope in high-risk areas in Morocco. The crude venom then simplest by electrical simulation. Strict quality control of the venom is essayed by different tests, mainly protein concentration, STS page, mass spectrometry, determination of LD50. The biological characterization of venom is done by physiopathological tests in mice and rabbits. In this example, the toxicity of the venom was determined by measuring the LD50. You can see here that the LD50 of the dangerous Androctonus mauritanicus and Androctonus australis hector venoms have higher toxic activity in mice when compared to Betus occitanus venom. Please note that the LD50 calculated by intravenous route is almost the same of LD50 calculated by the intraperitoneal route. This showed that the molecules responsible for mortality in the case of scorpion envenomation are molecules with low molecular weight, diffusing rapidly throughout the bloodstream, and their bioavailability is very high. This point is well demonstrated by the result of electrophoresis and mass spectrometry, showing that Androctonus mauritanicus and Betus occitanus venom are composed mainly by the low molecular weight molecules below 7 kilodalton, mainly miniproteins. Here, another result showing that the diffusion kinetics of the scorpion venom in the blood is very fast and completed already after 30 minutes. All these results explain the rapidity of appearance of symptoms within minutes after the scorpion sting and evolving to severe symptoms within a couple of hours only. Despite significant taxonomic difference among the species of scorpion, there is a large homology of the toxic effects of their venoms. During a sting, a very small amount of venom is inoculated, causing multiple symptoms: digestive, vegetative, neurological, cardiovascular, respiratory, and urinary signs. We can say that all systems of the body can be affected. The major effects are mainly due to neurotoxin that disrupt the conduction of nervous signal by affecting the function, especially of sodium and potassium ion channels, and using the relias of neuromediator that are responsible for all the alteration observed during scorpion envenomation and provoke pathophysiological action such as membrane destabilization, blocking of the central and peripheral nervous system, and alteration of muscle activity. As you can see on this slide, that there are similarities between the effect of the crude venom and its toxic fraction, showing that the toxins, the mini protein toxins, are the most responsible for the symptoms and the lethality observed during envenomation. So we can see that scorpion venom is mostly composed of very potent neurotoxin, causing considerable pain and paralysis that can lead to death. Our pharmacological study here in vitro by direct and indirect stimulation of an isolated neuromuscular preparation, Czech Bivantar services, showed that both Androctonus mauritanicus and Betus occitanus venom are simultaneously myotoxic and neurotoxic. Furthermore, the myotoxicity is the main cause of mortality and morbidity, which is predominantly associated with neurotoxic effects. On this slide, we show that the Androctonus mauritanicus and Betus occitanus venom cause an imbalance of serum electrolytes level with an important deficiency of magnesium. Given the role of magnesium in the function of the sodium-potassium pump, the key issue here is to administer a rich infusion in magnesium in envenomated patients. Now on venom composition part. In this study, we have collected 26 specimens of 13 scorpion species of different genus, Androctonus, Betus, Hottentota, and Scorpio. Our objective was to determine the mass fingerprinting analysis for each scorpion specimen collected. Fingerprinting mass analysis of the venoms were achieved by high-performance liquid chromatography coupled online to electrospray mass spectrometry. With simple visual inspection of the HPLC profile shows the complexity of venom and that each venom is different, containing several hundreds of bioactive molecules representing a broad range of biological properties. Here, the example of the genus Androctonus. Please note that scorpion venoms vary both at the inter- and intraspecific level. An intraspecific variation of different specimens and of the same species collected from different regions. This graph illustrates the summary of the results showing the variation inter- and intraspecific. This variation should be taken into account for future improvement of immunotherapy in Maghreb. Similar results were found in the genus Betus. About the composition of the scorpion venom, Our data revealed that about Androctonus mauritanicus and Betus occitanus venom are composed of 30% non-toxic molecules with low molecular weight corresponding to histamine, serotonin, and with high molecular weight biopolymers such as mucopolysaccharide and enzymes. And more than 70% are the toxic molecules consisting of toxins affecting the function of sodium, potassium, calcium, and chlorine channels. About the composition of the toxic fraction, we have more than 60% are toxins affecting the function of sodium channel. These toxins are ranging from 4 to 8 kilodalton and are active on the peripheral and central nervous system and responsible for more than 73% of mortality. About the smaller toxin, the molecular weight range between 3 to 4 kilodalton and affect the function of the active potassium, calcium, and chlorine channels. And these toxins are active only on the central nervous system and are responsible for toxicity, but not for mortality. Furthermore, in order to explore the diversity of toxin of the scorpion most dangerous in Morocco and to understand their effects, a combination of top-down and bottom-up approaches was applied using high-throughput mass spectrometry, nano-HPLC coupled to nano-electrospray MSMS. Interestingly, the study identified several toxins and revealed the molecular diversity of the scorpion most dangerous in Morocco, namely Androctonus mauritanicus and Betus occitanus, and identified their molecules that could be of interest with the therapeutic potential. Now I will move into the aspect of envenomation from the point of view epidemiological and scorpion medical interest. Worldwide, scorpion envenomation is a serious public health problem. The scorpion sting are estimated to more than 1.5 million cases with 2,608 per year. The highest incidence are generally located in the Mediterranean area with 1,600 annual lethal cases, followed by the Asian area and India, then a few dozen days in Latin America, Central and South Africa. In North Africa, scorpion envenomation is a serious problem, sadly, with high incidence and mortality rates. For a population of 157 million, we have more than 350,000 sting per year. We have 810 deaths, and the mortality percentage is of 0.52%. In Maghreb region, the higher incidence and mortality is located in Morocco and Algeria, where the population is higher. Here are the most venomous scorpions in the world belonging to the most dangerous genera, including Androctonus, Betus, Centroid, Lerus, and Tetus species. As you can see, they are found mainly in North Africa, the Middle East, Brazil, and Mexico. Notably, we can find in Morocco Betus occitanus and Androctonus mauritanicus, which is endemic only in Morocco. In North Africa, Morocco has the greatest diversity of scorpion fauna, explaining why Morocco has a high rate of endemism with more than 70%, followed by Algeria 58% and Egypt 70%. Here, all the dangerous scorpions in Maghreb, belong to the family Bichidae. Please note that the genus Andoroctonis has wide distribution in the Maghreb, and this genus has responsible for the fatal envenomation. So this genus is the key species for the development of an antivenom against the most dangerous scorpion envenomation in North Africa. And so we have the genus Betus that is widely distributed in Morocco, Algeria, Tunisia, and Libya. We have also Otontota, the genus Otontota, that is widely distributed in Algeria, Morocco, Libya, and is distributed also in Middle East and Asia, and medically relevant scorpion that could be evaluated, but we haven't any study conducted in Maghreb about this genus. Here you can see the medically relevant scorpion in Morocco. Amongst these 13 species, the most dangerous are Androctonus mauritanicus and Betus occitanus. Androctonus mauritanicus is incriminated in the most dangerous envenomation in Morocco with 67.5% and Betus occitanus with 20%. In Morocco, every year, scorpion envenomation entails more than 30,000 to 50,000, out of whom 4,000 with severe envenomation and more than 300 dead. The mortality percentage is 1%. Of course, this number can't be compared to COVID-19 that has a much higher incidence, but the mortality is about the same. And finally, I'm going to talk a bit about specific treatment and our experience in developing two antivenoms against the most dangerous scorpion in Morocco. As for treatment, the diversity in the composition of venom and thus the variability in the physiological effect they induce requires the conception of specific main of treatment that would be efficient, risk-free, stable in a tropical condition, and accessible. To this day, the only medication for envenomation is immunotherapy, also called antivenom since 1896, and is constituted of antibody of animal that were repeatedly injected with increasing quantities of venom. About the antivenom production in Maghreb, the Pasteur Institute of Maghreb country have stopped the antivenom production due to the difficulties to achieve the GMP production in accordance with the WHO guidelines. Only the Pasteur Institute of Tunisia continues to produce its own antivenom. For the management strategy of envenomated patients in Maghreb, antivenom is used in Algeria, Libya, Tunisia, but not in Morocco. The specific treatment in Morocco is not recommended and it's very controversial. The reason for this decision, first, venom has a faster action than antivenom. And secondly, the effects of venom are caused by the release of cell mediators that antivenom hasn't any effect. But now the technological development allowed to simplify the preparation of antivenom and to improve their effectiveness and purity. Now we talk about phagotherapy using efavirenz 2 fragments. Several studies have shown that phagotherapy is the most major therapeutic measure to use after scorpion envenomation. A study of clinical validation of efavirenz 2 by intravenous route showed that phagotherapy is able to induce rapid neutralization of circulating venom, better efficacy and less side effects, induce the resolution of clinical symptoms, reduction in hospitalization, and effective within 4 hours after treatment.
Is that all you see?
The favorite therapy is also able to induce a redistribution of venom from the peripheral compartment to the central compartment. So the question we can ask for Morocco is when we have antivenoms in our hospitals. For the antivenom production part, I'm going to share with you my experience working at the Butantan Institute. I will present here the main steps and the results of the development of two antivenoms, one monovalent against Androctonius mauritanicus venoms, and the other bivalent against Androctonius mauritanicus and Betus occitanus venom, and the results of the ability of the two antivenom developed to neutralize the most dangerous scorpion venom in Maghreb, namely Androctonus mauritanicus, Betus occitanus, and Androctonus australis hector. My collaboration with Butantan Institute allowed us to optimize the different process of antivenom production from venom collection to purification and neutralization control of the efavirenz to produce it. The main production steps are as follows. The first step is the preparation of the venom by adding adjuvants. Here is an immunization calendar for the production of antivenom. The monovalent antivenom was produced by immunizing horses with a pool of Androctonus mauritanicus scorpion venom collected from different regions of Morocco. And for the bivalent antivenom, a pool of Androctonus mauritanicus and Betus occitanus venom collected from different regions of Morocco was used. For production control, radial immunodiffusion was used and we noticed a good production titer after 3 weeks and the maximum was reached 40 days post-immunization. Once we have a good production titer is achieved, blood is collected and plasmapheresis is used to obtain the plasma. The first step is protein extraction by plasma precipitation with ammonium sulfate. This is followed by enzymatic digestion with pepsin to eliminate FC fragments and keep only the FAB2. Caprylic acid is subsequently added to eliminate lipids. And the thermocoagulation is used to eliminate undesired thermolabile proteins. FAB2 fragments are then isolated by tangential filtration. And ammonium sulfate is used again to eliminate non-specific proteins and FC fragments. Finally, tangential filtration with a 30 kilodalton Kotak membrane is used to eliminate salts. And after purification of the antivenom, protein content is accessed, and the 7% is typically achieved for monovalent antivenom, and for bivalent antivenom, the titer ratio is 8%. For quality control, the purity is first evaluated by electrophoresis and in parallel by ion exchange chromatography revealing a protein titer higher than 90% for active FAB2 fragments in both antivenoms. And the protective activity was determined by calculating the median dose of efficacy in mice. Our results showed that the monovalent has a strong neutralizing capacity against Androctonus mauritanicus venom. This is normal since the antivenom is produced against Androctonus mauritanicus venom. This monovalent antivenom has also a paraspecific effect against the Androctonus australis sector and Betus occitanus venom. About the bivalent antivenom, their neutralization capacity and their paraspecific effect is...
Doctor, now you have 5 minutes to go.
That of monovalent antivenom. Similar results were obtained by radial immunodiffusion tests and immunoblotting assays. And our conclusion, the ability of the two antivenom developed to neutralize scorpion envenomation of the most dangerous North Africa venom was found to be higher with the bivalent antivenom than with the monovalent antivenom. And I would like to express my gratitude to my colleagues from the Pasteur Institute and Butantan Institute, and thank you for your attention.